Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint the bellicose and aggressive Son of Dawn, Fafnir Rann. However, by following the methods and techniques in this guide, you can easily paint any Horus Heresy themed Imperial Fist. So when you're ready, grab those brushes, shake those paints, and let's get started. Now before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. Now as you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey, which is a nice starting point for the colours. You'll also notice I've not attached the shield onto his back. That just makes it a lot easier to access all the details on his back when we're painting. So the first thing we're going to do is paint the yellow armour, and the first colour we're going to be using is Avalanche Sunset. So what I'm going to do is just load up that base paint onto my palette, get a couple of brushes, and then add a little bit of water just so it's not too thick and goopy. Gives it a smoother finish that way as well. And all I'm going to do is just spin my brush a few times, just get a decent point, and then we're ready to start picking out the yellow armour. Now don't worry if you get some of this on the trim, we can always tidy that back up later on when we start applying the metallics. And you might want to add a second coat of yellow. There we are, I have a couple of thin coats now applied to the armour. Our base coating is done. So what we're now going to do is move on to applying some more colours to the yellow. We're going to start first by getting ironed in yellow and thinning this down with contrast medium. So three parts contrast medium to one part ironed in yellow. Then we're going to get some Avalanche Sunset and just tidy up those raised areas, finishing off with a highlight here and there of Dawn Yellow. But first of all, let's get a couple of dollops of contrast medium. So that's one, two, and then the third one. I'm just going to give that a quick wash. And then just get one paintbrush worth. Find in yellow, mix that in, and all I'm going to do is just get a decent point to my brush, and we're ready to start applying that to the armour. All I'm going to do is just start coating that all over and let it just drop in those recesses for some nice definition. With that contrast mix now dry, what we're now going to do is start applying the tidy up stage. So again, this is Avalanche Sunset, just taking our time picking out some of those raised areas. Again, this is going to give us some nice definition. Now that we're tidied up the yellow, we're just going to get some Dawn Yellow and we're just going to start picking out some of those edge highlights. Now, because there's a lot of banding on Fafnir Rann, you don't have to do lots and lots of edge highlighting, but there's a few little bits here and there, like the knee pads, the odd rivet, the feet, and some segments around the back. With the highlight now done, the yellow armour is finished. So what we're now going to do is move on to the silver details. Now I'm going to start first by base coat with Iron Hand Steel. Once that's applied, we're going to get Basilicarnum Grey, thin this down with a little bit of contrast medium and apply that all over those silver areas. Then we're going to tidy up using Iron Hand Steel. This is mainly on the vents and the axes. And then we're going to do an edge highlight of Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's start with our base coat. I'm just going to get some of that Iron Hand Steel, a little bit of water. Key thing here is get a decent point. And then we're ready to start base coating all those silver details. Now there's quite a lot of it's going to be banding on the armour. So I'm just going to start on the shoulder pad and work my way around. If you're not sure, just check the box art. With all those silver details now picked out, what we're now going to do is get Basilicarnum Grey, which we're thinned down with one part contrast medium. And we're just going to coat all over. And that's all over the silver details. With the Basilicarnum Grey now dry on all those silver details, what we're now going to do is get some Iron Hand Steel and pick out some of those flat areas just to tidy them up a little bit. So that's things like the axe and the vents on the back of the backpack. With the Iron Hand Steel now tidied up, what we're now going to do is get Stormhost Silver and start highlighting a load of the edges. So again, just work your way around on the banding and other details and just take your time. If you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with Iron Hand Steel and start again. There we are, with those silver highlights now done, we're now going to move on to our next area, which is going to be the burgundy details. So this is things like the weapon haft and leather details, such as the pouches and the belt. Now I'm going to start off with Barracknar Burgundy, then once that's dry, we're going to get some Basilicarnum Grey and slightly thin it down with a little bit of contrast medium. Then in some places, we're going to layer Screaming Pink, such as the leather details, but on the haft, we'll use that as a highlight. And then we'll finish off on all those details using a highlight of Pink Horror. But first of all, let's start with Barracknar Burgundy. So I'm just going to place a dollop there. Myself a small airbrush as well. Key thing here is getting that nice sharp point on your bristles. Then we're ready to start picking it out. So if I just spin him around here, you can see you've got the weapon hafts as well as the pouches at the back. So I'm just going to start on the pouches. Yeah, just take your time. You might need a second coat. There we are, that base coat now applied. As you can see here, I've also picked out things like the skull and the buckles using iron hand steel. So what we're now going to do is just coat over with a bit of siliconum grey. I thin this down slightly with one part contrast medium. With that contrast mix now dry, all I'm going to do now is get some Screamer Pink and I'm going to start highlighting on the leather. So I'm just going to go around the edges. When I get to the haft, I'm just going to pick out those little bits of binding using Screamer Pink as well. And just take your time, work your way around. With those edges now picked out in Screamer Pink, I'm just going to finish off with a little bit of pink horror. And what I'm going to do is not do every edge, I'm just going to start stabbing ever so slightly, just make it feel a little bit like rough and old leather, just on the extremities, like corners, where the light would naturally touch. With that highlight now done, our burgundy leather is finished. So what we're now going to do is move on to the gold details. Now I'm going to start first by using Retributor Armour as a base coat. Once that's dry, we're going to get Gulliman Flesh and coat over that. And then as a final highlight, we're going to get some Stormhost Silver and then use that. But first of all, we shall start with Retributor Armour. So all I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the palette. Don't have to go too mad. Then a little bit of water, just so it's a little bit more of a smoother coverage. And then just keep spinning my brush around until I get a decent point. And then we're ready to start picking out. So on the main body of Fafnir Rann, he's just got a couple of little fists on his axes to pick out. Again, you might need to do a couple of coats here. And on his backpack or the shield with all the extra details on it, there's also the dagger there. Again, check the box art if you're not sure. The details now base coated, we're going to get Gulliman Flesh and coat over. Just be mindful not to get any of that Gulliman Flesh on the silver details. If you do, just tidy back up. Now that contrast is dry, we're just going to get a little bit of Stormhost Silver and then just start highlighting elements of that gold. I'm not going to go mad, just picking out little bits on the gauntlet, like the fingers, just where the light's going to naturally catch. With them gold details now picked out, what we're now going to do is move on to the white details. So this is just going to focus on the chapter symbol and it's going to be that white round field behind the fist. So we're going to start off first with Grey Seer as a base coat. Once that's dry, we're just going to do a little edge highlight of Korax White. So first of all, let's get some Grey Seer. Apply a little bit of that to the palette. And again, tiny touch of water. Make sure we get a decent point to our brush as well. Once we're happy with that, start picking out that round symbol. And in some places, you might need to do a second coat. Now that we've applied Grey Seer, what we're going to do now is just get some Korax White and just start working our way around the edge, picking out that highlight. With the white of the symbol now done, what we're now going to do is move on to the black detail. So for this, we're going to start with a Baden Black as a base coat. Then we're going to do our first highlight of Mechanica Standard Grey. And then just on some of the extreme areas, we're going to finish off with a little bit of Dawnstone. But first of all, let's start that Baden Black. So as always with a base paint, just apply a little bit to the palette. Teeny tiny bit of water just for that nice smoothness, and then we'll get a good point to it as well. And just take your time in doing that, make sure you get a good point. Now, there's quite a few little bits to focus on for the black, so I'm going to start on the actual fist symbol. There's other details like the actual rim of his shoulder pad. You've got the axes here, there's cables. If you're not entirely sure, just check the box art. With that symbol and other black details picked out, what we're now going to do is move on to our first highlight, which is Mechanica Standard Grey. And take your time. If you're making a mistake, you can always tidy back up with a Baden Black. That first highlight, Mechanica Standard Grey, now done. We're just going to finish off with a little dot here and there of Dawnstone. So I'm not going to go too mad, just the extreme areas where the light will touch. Those highlights now done on the black, we're now going to move on to the skin. So for this, we're going to start with Kislev Flesh as a base coat. We'll probably apply a couple of coats of this just to build up that colour. Once that's dry, we're going to get some Gulliman Flesh, thin that down with some contrast medium, just get into those recesses, then tidy back up with Kislev Flesh. We'll do a highlight of Screaming Skull, and then just to pick out his eyes, we'll use a little bit of a Baden Black. But first of all, let's start with layering up that Kislev Flesh. I'm just going to get a dollop onto my palette, a little bit of water, and even like a base coat, I still thin it down. And then again, as always, key, get a good point to your brush. And then we're ready to start picking out the details on the face. So all I'm going to do is just work my way around and just apply that. And like I said, you might have to do a second coat if you need to. With the skin now layered up, we're just going to get Gulliman Flesh thinned down with a little bit of contrast medium. So that's one part Gulliman Flesh to one part contrast medium. And all I'm going to do is just apply that to the skin. Be mindful it just doesn't pull down too much. If you do find that happening, just get your brush to soak up a little bit here and there. Now that we've applied Gulliman Flesh thin down with contrast medium, what we're now going to do is just tighten up those raised areas using some Kislev Flesh. And take your time, and if you do make any mistakes, you can always drop a little bit more Gulliman Flesh into the recesses. With those raised areas of the skin now tidied up, we're just going to get some Screaming Skull and start picking out those highlights. Just going to keep it to things like the nose, the brows, the ears, not too much. Now that we've done that final highlight of the skin, all we're going to do now is just get some Abaddon Black and just drop that in the eyes of Fafnir Rann. Just add a little bit of definition. Those eyes now picked out, the face of Fafnir is done. So we're now going to move on to his hair and beard. We're going to start first by laying with Scrag Brown. Once that's applied, we're then going to coat over with Gulliman Flesh straight from the pot. When that's dry, we're then going to use Scrag Brown again as our highlight. So first of all, let's get some Scrag Brown out of the pot and place that onto the palette. Just going to get a little bit more from there. Add a slight touch of water, not too much, not too thin. Once I've loaded my brush up and got a nice point, we're then ready to start picking out Fafnir's hair. So I'm just going to start on the top. Because I've got that grey undercoat, we might need to do a second coat. With the hair now layered in Scrag Brown, we're just going to coat over it with Gulliman Flesh. And again, I'm just using this straight from the pot. With the Gulliman Flesh now dry, what we're now going to do is just get Scrag Brown again and then just use that as our highlight. Because it's going to be a little bit lighter than that first one after it's been toned down with Gulliman Flesh. There we are, Fafnir Rann's hair is now done. So what we're now going to do is finish the model off by picking out the gems. Now for the red gems, we're going to use Spirit Stone Red, and for any blue gems, we'll also be using Soulstone Blue. Now I'm going to be doing this on the shield because that's the area that's got most of the gems on it. So what I'm going to do is get myself a little bit of Spirit Stone Red, just apply that to the palette just so I don't over make it all thick and goopy. So once I've got a nice point to my brush, I'm going to pick up the shield. And then we've got one gem on the blade just here. So all I'm going to do is just apply that. Once it's dry, just apply a second coat. There's also at the back, there's just some little control nodules. So I'm going to pick a couple of those out as well, just for like buttons and stuff. With the red gems and buttons now picked out, what we're now going to do is just pick out those blue ones with Soulstone Blue. And in some places, you might want to add a second coat. With those blue gems now picked out and the shield now glued to Fafnir Rann, all that's left to do is base him in a colour scheme that matches the rest of your army. With Fafnir Rann now painted and based, he's ready to bring death and destruction to the enemies of Dawn and Holy Terror. Now there's a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when doing any edge highlights, try and maintain a nice point to your brush. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up at a later point if you need to. Also, when using shades and contrasts, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. And also, like we did in this video, if you are using lots of metallics, it's worth changing your water after you've done that. You don't want to contaminate all the other colours with metallic flecks. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed painting your own Fafnir Rann, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.